Welcome back, my dear students. In continuation of the derivation for three-dimensional continuity equation, we have derived that this is a three-dimensional continuity equation. Just if we observe this equation in a deeper manner, what is that one here? One term I will take here now. Dou rho u divided by dou x here. So total u is changing, velocity along the x direction is changing, and also the density of the fluid is also changing in this equation here now. Why? Because the density is also available in the bracket, means we are differentiating the density also in all the term here now. So density is along the y direction is also changing, along the z direction is also changing, with respect to the time also the density is changing here now. So therefore, whatever the equation we have derived here now, this is three dimensional. This is one, it is a three dimensional. And next one, the same equation, because density is you are differentiating, density is not constant here now. Density is not constant here now. So therefore, this is the equation for the compressible flow. Means, in the derivation, this up to this equation, if we derived, this is the equation for the compressible flow here. Why it is compressible flow? Density is varying because it is a differentiating with respect to the space coordinates like x, y, z here. And also the density is also varying with respect to the time. That's why this is the equation for the compressible flow here now. 3D compressible flow. Next one, the one parameter, that is a density, it is also varying with respect to the time here now. So the time is taken here now. This here time is taken. So therefore, with respect to the time, any parameter if it is changing, then that kind of the fluid flow is called as the unsteady fluid flow. So therefore, this equation is also for the unsteady flow here now. Means what? The parameter density is varying with respect to the time here. Next one, in case of the derivation, if they are asked to find the equation for the, that is for incompressible steady flow. So for incompressible steady flow here, if the equation for the incompressible steady flow, what the condition, what how this equation will be changes its form, how this one now, incompressible fluid flow means density is constant here now. So density is constant means what? So next one is d rho is equal to 0, this is one. And steady flow means the temperature is, the time is there here now, with respect to the time no parameters are changing, means what? D rho divided by dt is will becomes 0 here, means what? The for the steady flow here, so this will becomes a 0 for the steady flow here now. And the density will be taken outside the differential, that equation, then equated to the 0 here now. Is equal to 0 is there here now. At the last, for the incompressible steady flow, this equation will becomes dou u divided by dou x plus dou v divided by dou y plus dou w divided by dou z is equal to 0 here now. This is the equation what we are getting here now. This is the three-dimensional incompressible steady flow here. For unsteady means this term will exist. D rho by dt will exist here now. For here this equation we can write for the 2D flow, 1D flow also. If it is only flow is along only x direction is there, this term will become 0. Along the y, along the z direction, dou v by dou y, dou w by dou z will become 0. Only it will becomes dou u divided by dou x is equal to 0 here. If the only 2D flow is there, x and y direction. So these two term will exist. dou w divided by dou z will becomes 0. So therefore, accordingly, what is our requirement? Based on that, we have to alter this equation here now. Generally, we are getting this equation for the compressible unsteady fluid flow, 3D flow, and accordingly for incompressible steady flow, this equation will becomes in a different way here, because density is not, that is, the density is constant and density is not varying with respect to the time here. So next one, so what is this equation? Actually, what is this equation here now? So equation is, this equation is, it is the dou u divided by dou x plus dou v divided by dou y plus it is the dou w divided by dou z is equal to 0. See, what actually this equation tells here now? In case of the numericals here now, in case of the numericals, they will give the equation for the u, equation for the v, for the 2D flow. If the 2D flow is there here now, for 2D flow here, this will become 0 for the 2D flow, where that is the x and y is there, along the x and y is there, then this will become 0. Then the equation will becomes what? Dou u divided by dou x plus dou v divided by dou y is equal to 0 here now. So next one is what here now? Sometimes in the numerical, for the u one relation will be given, for the v one relation will be given in a vector form here now. How this one? The resultant velocity is equal to 2xyi plus 3xy square j plus 4xy square k. So in this, so only 2D flow, in the 2D flow these two will be given here now. Next, this is the u, this is the v here now. So next, what we have to do? We have to substitute this u value here and v value here, differentiate with respect to x this u value, differentiate this v with respect to y value. If it comes 0 for the x some coordinate 1, 1 here now, if it comes 0, it indicates what? It indicates that fluid is flowing. It indicates that existence of the fluid flow. It indicates what? The fluid is irrotational. Very, very important here now. So it, what it tells here now, it is a physical significance. The physical significance of this the continuity equation is, if the, after the differentiation of the velocities with respect to the space coordinates here, if it comes 0, it indicates that fluid is the irrotational, here irrotational steady flow and incompressible flow, and that fluid is existing. Very, very important that checking. Mathematically, we are checking here now the fluid flow is exist or not. How? After the differentiation, if it comes 0, it indicates that the fluid is existing and it is irrotational and it is steady and incompressible here in this equation here now. Very, very important that turning point mathematically we can check here now. Sometimes in the numerical, what they will give? So in case of the 2D flow here now, they will give u here now. They will ask to find out the v. V is what? They will find here now. So what you will do here now? Dou v divided by dou x is equal to dou u minus dou u divided by dou x here now. Dou v divided by dou y, dou u divided by here now, dou x here now. So to get this dou v, what we are doing? Integrating here now. It is dou v is equal to minus dou u divided by dou x into dou y here now. If I integrate it here, I will get that v value here now. Sometimes that kind of numericals will also ask here now. So one velocity component will be given, another velocity component has to find by applying this continuity, 3D continuity equation here now. These are the kinds of that the numericals they may ask on the continuity, that equation here now. So this is about the continuity equation. We will see in the next video lecture under some more that very important topic here. Thank you. Thank you very much.